The cautionary stance of maintaining the central bank rate as a way of hedging against risks like inflation taken by the Bank of Uganda in the previous monetary policy seems to have paid off.
Growth in 23-24 is going to be anywhere between 5 to 6%. But the government objective is to have it at 6%, somewhere close to 6%. And that's why we're taking these policy measures, that how can we ensure that notwithstanding what we're seeing now, we remain close to 6%, which is the government objective. So we think that by lowering the CBR and also lowering the CRR, we are creating conditions that are going to support growth to be closer to the 6% government objective that we talked about.
The Bank of Uganda says inflation has dropped to less than its target of 5%. This juxtapositioned with other factors like a strengthening shilling has prompted the bank to reduce its benchmark lending rate to 9.5% from 10% in June, a move that is likely to spark growth in the economy.
For example, if we just do back of envelope calculation, reducing the CRR alone by 50 basis points would mean that we're injecting, looking at the deposit available, the deposit in the commercial banks, we are talking about an injection of around 160 million Uganda shillings, just on back of envelope calculation.
The reduction in the central bank rate and cash reserve requirement is also expected to increase liquidity that is available for the commercial banks to on-lend to the private sector. Atengo Ego offered assurances that the depreciation of the shilling that has been registered since the World Bank's announcement of funding withdrawals for new projects should not be something to worry about. Story by Ben Ojambo for the news.